In this video, I'm going to give a review of a very good practical book of the pediatrics. Its name is Pediatric Differential Diagnosis. It does not only consist of the differential diagnosis, but it gives the complete history, examination, investigation, checklist of a specific symptom. And on the basis of all the history, examination, and investigation, it gives the differential diagnosis of that particular symptom, which helps to reach a specific diagnosis depending upon the results. So we will check its sections. First of all, it consists of it gives a brief review of pattern of taking history and examination, and it give a short comprehensive checklist on the interpretation of the investigation and discuss some genetic and dysmorphologies. Then there is the section 1, which is the neonatology. Section 2 consists of the cardiology. Section 3 consists of the gastroenterology. Section 4 consists of the pulmonology. Section 5 consists of hematology. Section 6 consists of neurology. Section 7 consists of the allergy and infections. Section 8 consists of the genitourinary system. Section 9 consists of the ear, nose, and throat. Section 10, bone and joint. Section 11 consists of the endocrinological problems of the children. Section 12 consists of the dermatology. And section 13 consists of the miscellaneous diseases of the children, such as the edema and poisoning. Now we will see briefly from the inside of the book. First of all, this is the checklist of the history and examination, in which the systemic review of the symptoms is given, the general skin, eyes, and then different systemic checklist is given. Here are the some tables consisting of the the history of the different symptoms, that what question you have to ask if there is a presentation of the specific symptom. So these are the tables, and there is the examination review checklist, in which the different examinations questions are given. So here are the different examination checklist of the different organs. Then here comes the section in which there is the interpretation of the investigations is given, and then genetic and dysmorphological abnormalities are discussed. Then comes the section of the neonatology, in which first of all premature baby is discussed, in which the evaluation of the preterm baby, long-term complications of the prematurity are given. Then comes the section neonatal jaundice, also history, examination, then management are given. Here is the investigation needed. The discussion of the different diseases, pathological diseases associated with the jaundice. Then comes the chapter of respiratory distress in the newborn infants. Then intestinal obstruction. Then seizures in the newborn. You can see each symptoms is discussed briefly, and its history, examination, investigation, and even management is also given. So it's a very good practical book. Then comes the section small for gestational age infants or IUGR. Then comes the section of hypoglycemia. Then comes vitamin K deficiency. Then section 2 is consists of the cardiology. And in this section, different diseases of the cardiovascular system of the children are discussed. First of all, the congenital heart diseases of the children. in which different diseases and their interpretation and the investigation and differential diagnosis are discussed. Then the gastroenterology system, section number 3. Failure to thrive, it is very common finding or presentation of the children. Then comes acute abdominal pain, then vomiting, persistent chronic or recurrent diarrhea, recurrent abdominal pain, constipation, hepatomegaly and splenomegaly, cystic fibrosis. Then comes the section 4, which consists of the pulmonology, and it includes diseases of cough and wheeze in the children, stridor, aspiration pneumonia, pleural effusion. Then comes the section 5, which consists of the hematology. It includes pallor or anemia, then bleeding disorders, and then comes the section 6, consists of the neurology, in which discussion of the evaluation of neurological diseases is then altered sensorium, developmental delay in the children, seizures, headaches in the children, its complete evaluation, epilepsy, cerebral palsy, acute flaccid paralysis. Section 7 consists of the allergy and infection. It consists of the disease, short duration fever, persistent fever, allergy in the children. Then comes immunodeficiency disorders. Section 8 consists of the genitourinary system, which consists of the urinary tract infections in the children, hematuria and proteinuria, different diseases associated with these symptoms, and the investigation and history findings are discussed. Then comes the enuresis or bedwetting, which is a very common problem in the children. Then come inguinoscrotal swelling. Here comes the section ear, nose and throat, in which swellings in the neck are discussed. Then hearing loss, otitis media. Then comes the section of bones and joint, consists of the joint pain or swelling in the children, limping in the children, juvenile idiopathic arthritis, developmental dysplasia of the hip joint. Then comes the endocrinology section, which consists of the short stature, different diseases causing short stature, and their brief discussion is done in this chapter. Then comes the chapter of obesity, then precocious puberty in the girls and delayed puberty in the girls, and then precocious puberty in the boys and delayed puberty in the boys, diabetes mellitus, ambiguous genitalia. And then comes the section of dermatology, in which skin rashes, different types of the skin rashes in the children and their associated diseases are discussed. Then comes the section consisting of the miscellaneous diseases in the children, such as edema, poisoning, and here comes the end of the book. So it was a brief review of this book named Pediatric Differential Diagnosis. I have made some videos from this book's topics, and many people have asked me to give a review of this book. So I hope you like it.